actually, you're the first time actually here visiting. Colby, it's like I never left. I said, it's like I've never left.
Yes. Only now it's warmer.
Warmer and chilly's here.
Another wonderful day in BC. I'm still at Colby's place at the Kalamalka Lake. I mean, I don't know if you can see it, but this water is just, it's got this beautiful blue color, although
very Caribbean-esque.
That's the way to describe it. Yes, but there were a lot of bushfires in the area, so everything is sort of smoky at the moment. But anyway, we're going for a boat right now. Okay, Captain, where are we going?
We are just exploring, nowhere in particular. It's amazing, being on a lake, you don't have to go anywhere. You end up where you started.
Perfect, I love it. Bobby, where are we now?
This is called the Happy Face Cliff, and it looks like there's some young people trying to pull up the nerve to jump off right now. It is about 10 meters from the high point.
So it's a thing here, right? Everyone jumps off. All right, Colby's turn. Wow, this kid is soft. Go, Colby! Wow, nice one, mate. Well done, you're.
Well, that's the little one. The big cliff's just down the lake. I'm not going off that one. You can.
No. I'm okay.
The next one's only 30
I'll
meters.
I'll jump off the boat, mate. So this is your engine?
Yeah. Corvette motor.
Wow. Looks serious.
Tough day.
Tough day. Another tough day in Canada.
Whew. He's got a really hard life.
Tough life. Every day is just getting harder and harder while I'm here.
Harder and harder to leave.
High five.
Whoop.
What?
Lost my noodle.
Me too. Where are we up to today?
We're gonna take this fun little car and explore the Okanagan and visit a couple little wineries.
That's it. What's the car?
It is a 1976 Triumph Spitfire.
Looking fabulous.
Thank you. Right, so it's time to leave. I'm leaving Lake Country today. Yesterday we put new tires on. She's back to Buttlock's Adventure Cross, Bridgestone tires. So novice again, because I'm hoping to do a little bit of dirt on my way across the United States soon. Let's see the rear one. And that's the rear one. Proper tires, right? And today, Colby's joining me for a day ride. Colby, where are we going?
We're going from Lake Country over across to Caslow via some really fun twisty roads, and then I'm gonna go up to Revelstoke and come home, and you're gonna camp at a nice Mirror Lake campground.
Excellent. So how many kilometers are you gonna do today?
More than you.
Like double, 600 something.
Yeah, I'll do about 630, and you're gonna do probably 315, 320.
Yeah, I like that one better. Hey, Colby.
Hey, how's she going?
Oh my God, you're in my head now.
So, oh, I don't know if you want me there.
Oh, Jesus. You're so loud. Oh, my God. I normally don't get to test this feature on Sina because I never travel with anyone. So this is going to be interesting. No singing, mate, okay?
Only some light singing.
Right.
The good songs.
Here we go. Oh, back on Nobby's. Chili feels different. Yay. Colby, so this is the last view of the lake, hey?
Yeah, after this, we're not going to see the lake anymore.
So long, beautiful lake. I'm recording now.
Hello.
You're on YouTube.
I'm on YouTube. Holy.
That's a nice lake, hey?
It's beautiful.
And the trees are so tall. It's a very beautiful.
This is actually a really good fishing lake, and in the winter people fish on the ice. It's frozen like 2 feet thick of ice.
Oh wow. Did they wouldn't drive a car on it, hey?
I saw a car ride on it last year.
And we are about to get on a ferry. Where's the ferry for today?
Almost there.
Almost there. It's a short one, isn't it?
Yeah, it only takes the ferry 15 minutes to load and go across.
And hello from the other side.
That was a bad joke.
It was a great joke.
Thank you.
And that's it. We're on the other side. What an adventure! And we have made it.
Here we are in Sandon.
Here we are. What are we going to see here?
We're in Sandon. It used to be a mining town, and now there's a tiny little powerhouse and a mining museum.
Is it a ghost town?
It's not a ghost town.
People live here all year round?
It's just an empty town. There's one family, I think, that runs all of it now.
Oh, really? Okay, yeah. So it's not really a town. I mean,
town is a rough use of the term.
With the buses here?
There is a project in Canada where they're trying to maintain and restore a lot of the old electric buses that all the cities used to use. And so the people in the society have asked Sandon here to look after the buses while they make them nice again.
Oh,
And then as they make them nice, they send them back to the town so they can be used again.
Aww. Okay. Let's go for a ride. And we can do a little bus tour. This is it. This is the bus from the inside. So cool.
All over Canada. Ottawa, Thunder Bay, Ontario, more Ontario, Montreal, Halifax, Winnipeg, Toronto, Vancouver, Saskatoon, Edmonton, Calgary. They had these electric buses all over the country.
You guys ready?
Yeah.
And now we are walking for a very long time. Feels like 5 kilometers.
Exactly 500 meters.
Probably more than that, but uphill. Right, so we are nearly there. That's the power, what is it?
Power
station. Yeah.
It's the big generator they use to get everything running.
So this power station is still operational?
Yep. It has been making power for something like 120 years.
Wow.
Continuously.
And so they only supply power here to the village, right?
No, it backfeeds into the BC Hydro lines and
really?
Sends power out.
Oh, wow.
So they have an agreement with their local power company, BC Hydro, that they sell power to BC Hydro and then it goes wherever it needs to go.
So where are we now?
We are going into the Sandon Historical Museum. These two buildings here, the one on the left is the original postmaster shop from 1895, and this one that's being restored is the original butcher shop from 1900.
There you go. He knows it. He knows stuff.
1898 is it's the height actually of Sandon. Beautiful town built up in like 6 years. It's only 6 years since everything started.
And so after the opera, maybe a cigar had been left cast off and there was a fire and all this burnt.
So after our little introduction, we find out a lot of things. Back in the days, 5,000 people lived here and they had how many hotels?
Three.
Now that's three breweries.
Oh, three breweries.
29 hotels and?
A lot of brothels.
Like,
85 brothels.
85 brothels. 29 hotels, three breweries. Clearly they have their priorities. Are you ready?
Yep. What a sing-along.
Thank you.
For firmness and plumpness. I found some old medicine for you. Bitters for female weakness.
Yes, I need it badly these days. Let's do it.
You need to be so aware of ghosts that they put the sign up twice.
I can hear the ghosts walking. I don't want to go there.
Well, you gotta go in there. There's a warning of ghosts and trolls, but you have to explore it. This is where the trolls and ghosts live. It's inside the mine shaft. In you go.
I don't want to go there.
It's the mine at it. It's just for you.
It's very... Ah! Go away. Okay. Time to
go. How many ghosts did you see?
One. He had a long beard.
I don't know who that could be.
What is this? There was a 5% chance of rain for today. This is bullshit.
I know. So now we have a rain. But that's okay, we only have 40 k's, yeah? What is it?
So that one from the things on it is like all the Japanese people were interred in this area.
Uh-huh.
During World War II after they bombed Pearl Harbor.
Uh-huh.
So that one is looks like one of the old cabins, and this is just a beautiful piece of art.
Yeah, super so cool. How's that?
Perfect.
We have made it to our, well, my final destination. I believe this is where I'm supposed to stay in camp. I have no idea where I'm going. I'm just following Colby today. But here we're going to stop for lunch and say goodbye.
I'm very excited for this.
Here we are with our healthy food.
Mm-hmm.
Super healthy.
At the end of the day. Yep. So much cholesterol and even more tomato sauce.
All the good cholesterol though, it's delicious.
Enjoy. Bye. Thank you.
I'll see you next time.
Bye, Colby. Thanks for stopping by. I enjoy when you come by. Someday come by when you're not exhausted.
I know. I hope one day it will happen. All right. Right, safe, huh? Bye. All right. So, Colby's going home. And I'm going to the campground, which is 4.7 kilometers away. I like that distance at the end of the day.
It's all happening. I'm getting my hair done today. It's a big day today. How's my hair?
But I have